Today's video is going to be all about insulin resistance, what it is and how it is related to metabolic syndrome, type 2 diabetes, and PCOS. Now, I have several videos on my channel about various topics surrounding insulin resistance, and I usually give a quick recap at the start of these videos talking about what insulin resistance is. But I realized that I didn't have a full dedicated video, so I thought I would make one. And this is going to be the first in a two-part series. Today's video is going to be all about insulin resistance, as I said, what it is and how it relates to metabolic syndrome, type 2 diabetes, and PCOS. And then in the second video, we're going to do a deep dive into how to reverse it. Because yes, PCOS and all of the associated diseases that I just mentioned are reversible. So stick around if you want to know more about insulin resistance. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name's Kate. I'm a health coach and I post videos on a high-fat, nutrient-dense way of eating. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, feel free to share, and make sure to subscribe. And make sure to follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook, where I share new posts every single day. Now, before we even get into anything today, I just want to say that insulin resistance and metabolic syndrome are the exact same thing. Metabolic syndrome used to actually be called insulin resistance syndrome. So if you know that you have metabolic syndrome, but you weren't too sure if you are insulin resistant or not, you are. And in case you're not familiar, metabolic syndrome is characterized by five main components: a large waist circumference, high triglycerides, low HDL cholesterol, high blood pressure, and high fasting blood sugar. If you have three or more of these symptoms, you'll be diagnosed with metabolic syndrome, AKA insulin resistance. And I like referring to it as insulin resistance because the label of metabolic syndrome is very vague. It doesn't tell you anything about what it actually is and what is causing the symptoms. Whereas with the label of insulin resistance, we can see that the root issue is our body resisting insulin. But anyways, I'm getting ahead of myself. We're gonna get into this a little bit more in the video. But I just wanted to make this really clear at the start of the video that insulin resistance and metabolic syndrome are the same, because this is something that I feel like not many people know. So we're gonna start off the video talking about what insulin resistance is and what causes it, and then we'll get into its relationship with type 2 diabetes and PCOS. What is insulin resistance? Insulin is a hormone in our body whose main role is to keep our blood sugar at the right level. It is responsible for signaling our cells to take in glucose, which in turn brings our blood sugar down. So when our blood sugar goes up, after we eat, for example, the pancreas releases insulin, which takes the excess glucose from our bloodstream to our cells. Insulin resistance is when our cells no longer respond to insulin correctly and cannot easily take in the excess glucose from your blood. This leads to insulin levels remaining higher than they should for long periods of time and results in side effects such as excess abdominal fat, skin tags, and dark skin patches. It also causes your HDL cholesterol to decrease and your triglycerides to increase. But why do our cells start resisting insulin in the first place? When we eat foods rich in carbohydrates, they are broken down by the body into glucose. This glucose enters our bloodstream and causes our blood glucose to rise. Insulin is then released to deal with the excess blood sugar, taking it from our bloodstream and putting it in our cells. And this is a normal function of the body. Our bodies are equipped to deal with periodic rises in blood sugar. However, if we are constantly eating high-carb foods throughout the day, which are broken down into glucose, our blood sugar is constantly spiking and might not even have time to come back down to baseline before we eat again. And then more insulin is pumped out to deal with the excess blood glucose. And then our cells become overwhelmed and start resisting insulin because they are already filled with glucose. And this turns into a vicious cycle where the high insulin is causing insulin resistance, and then the insulin resistance is causing high insulin, and the problem gets progressively worse until it manifests as other diseases. having high glycemic variability, which is when your blood sugar levels fluctuate a lot throughout the day, is associated with insulin resistance. If your blood sugar is constantly spiking throughout the day, this means that your body is pumping out a lot of insulin to deal with it. And if your insulin doesn't have a chance to come back down to baseline before you eat again, then your insulin stays high, and this is where the cycle starts. Having high insulin is known as hyperinsulinemia, and this is really what leads to all the associated symptoms and consequential diseases. Type 2 diabetes. Type 2 diabetes is defined as having high blood sugar or hyperglycemia, and it relates to insulin resistance because insulin resistance actually causes type 2 diabetes. Because in the early stages of insulin resistance, the body is producing enough insulin to deal with the excess glucose. So your blood sugar remains what is considered to be normal, but your insulin is high. And this is why insulin resistance often gets missed. Doctors routinely test fasting glucose, but not fasting insulin. And like I said, in the early stages, the excess insulin is enough to keep blood sugar in check. But as time goes on, your body will not be able to produce enough insulin to keep up. And this is when you're going to start to see a rise in your fasting blood sugar. And you will eventually be diagnosed with prediabetes or type 2 diabetes. PCOS. PCOS, which stands for polycystic ovarian syndrome, is a syndrome that only women can develop. And PCOS is the number one cause of female infertility. In Western countries, 1 in 10 women of childbearing age have it. Symptoms include missed periods, weight gain, excessive hair growth, and acne. Women with PCOS have difficulty getting pregnant and often seek out infertility treatment. And a lot of women are surprised to hear that PCOS is connected to insulin resistance because, like type 2 diabetes, most women are told that it is something they are stuck with for life. But the reality is that the vast majority of PCOS cases are caused by insulin resistance. And by addressing insulin resistance, you can reverse PCOS. To be diagnosed with PCOS, you have to have 2 out of 3 of the main symptoms: an irregular period, a hormonal imbalance with high androgen levels, androgens being male sex hormones such as testosterone, and cysts in the ovaries. Now, there is a lot of confusion surrounding PCOS. As I previously said, a lot of women who are diagnosed are told that it is something that can only be managed, and they're prescribed drugs such as metformin. And what is interesting about metformin is that it is a drug that improves insulin sensitivity, which goes to prove that insulin resistance is the root cause. And metformin does an amazing job at improving symptoms. 90% of women with PCOS who are prescribed the drug see improvements. However, it does not come without a long list of side effects. So reversing insulin resistance naturally might be a better option. And I know that a lot of women who are prescribed metformin and men who are prescribed it for diabetes or insulin resistance as well are not aware of the side effects. And I do have a whole video going over these side effects, which you can check out afterwards if you want to know more. But let's talk about exactly how insulin resistance is related to PCOS. Because it's actually hyperinsulinemia, which is high insulin, that causes the 3 main symptoms. Every month, just before ovulation, there should be a big spike in the hormone estrogen. All estrogen is made from testosterone, but high insulin levels block the ovaries from converting it, and the spike in estrogen doesn't happen. So you do not ovulate, and the eggs remain in the ovaries and become cysts. And you are left with high testosterone levels as a result. And those are the 3 main symptoms which we spoke about earlier: irregular periods, high testosterone, and cysts in the ovaries. Anyways, guys, I'm going to wrap this video up here. I hope that you found it helpful. I will link part 2 when it's up on the end screen, so make sure to check that video out afterwards. Like I said, that one is going to be going into exactly how to reverse insulin resistance. And I want to hear from you guys in the comment section down below. Let me know what you thought of the video. Did you find it helpful? Let me know, do you have insulin resistance or PCOS or type 2 diabetes? Or maybe you have metabolic syndrome and didn't even realize that it was related. Let me know down below. I love chatting with you guys in the comment section. And if you did like this video, I will link part two here when it's up. In the meantime, I'll put my insulin resistance playlist, which has a whole bunch of other videos which you might find helpful. If you want to catch up on my most recent upload, you can find it here. And if you want to check out my keto diet and carnivore diet coaching programs, they'll be right here. Thanks, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye.